Thank you to everyone who sent really, really, really sweet messages. People who left really sweet comments. They meant a lot. I don't know. No, I will not feed you. Huge thank you to everyone who watched my first video. That was really long. Yeah, I had to put it in two parts. But you came back, and that is very sweet. I plan on making sure this video isn't nearly as long. So my face is washed, it's already primed, hair is up. It's not like a typical belly bun, just a cute little, I'm cleaning my house bun. So I'm not too fancy today. Kind of this little like painter smock sort of deal. I think this might be like maybe my mom's, I don't know. But y'all, I just spent the past like 3 hours watching Crikey is the Irwins, and I love them so much. So every time they did the intro where they had Steve Irwin talking about his children and his dreams, weeping. I have to do a kookaburra one day. I don't know how, but it's a goal. If you watched my first and only video, you hopefully have an idea of what I do. If you thought that was too long, I understand. I will go ahead and re-explain. So yes, this is a makeup tutorial channel. These are the videos I'm doing, but they're a little different. I am going to be doing like full face and eyeshadow and mascara, and which I forgot to do last time. This is different because it's sort of like specialty fantasy makeup. I actually have the one I did right here with me. So these are makeup appliques, and they're basically really fanciful, sparkly things that you stick on your face. And this is the like Firebird one that I did. I use them in a ballet production every year, and we use this for the character of the Red Robin. Yes, robins are usually brown with like a red chest. Our dancer, our character is fully red and beautiful and sparkly. Today, to kind of do like a little calmer, more smoothing sort of color palette, we are doing my little creation of a Bluebird. So this is what it looks like. This is what would go over your, at least with my left eyebrow. And it's each bird kind of have, the layout is different for each one. So this one will not only have something over the eyebrow, it also has a piece right here. So it's gonna have this sort of like gladiator look. It's just kind of what happened. I washed all my brushes yesterday, so hopefully, I don't know, they'll be cleaner and be better for my skin. Let's go. I tried filming this like 4 times yesterday and it did not go in my favor, so we're trying again. One of the reasons being, you want to make sure that when you use your eyeshadow primer, you actually grab your primer and not eyelash glue. Mm-hmm. Another reason why this just did not go over the way I wanted to yesterday is because with this being a blue applique, I really, 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 really wanted to do blue eyeshadow because, you know, at least for me, this is just me, I can't speak for everybody, I typically don't wear blue eyeshadow. It's something that really can bring out a lot of red, like redness in my skin, because my skin, it's not perfect, it's still healing and get splotchy and gets breakouts. And if I wear blue eyeshadow, it just brings all that out. Also, I tend to do better with oranges and purples for eyeshadow color, but this would be fun excuse to do blue eyeshadow, and blue eyeshadow can turn on you very quickly. So yesterday we tried these two. It didn't go very well. So we're going to try to do better today. One of the things I did for a roll a few years ago was I did like a glove bronzy and gold and then like did blue on the outside. So I'm going to try that technique today and see if that goes anywhere for me. I think we'll do a little just kind of normal base in one of these guys, and then we'll do this one is a bronzy sparkly one. Stop being so shiny and bright. Okay. Apparently what I need to do is back here. Actually, let's see what happens if we do the sparkly stuff over the whole eyelid. I want this one to be more, I don't know if you guys can see that at all. I want this applique to be a bit more glamour, a little less on like stage focus, I think. So let's just go ahead and make it all shiny. And if this ends up looking ridiculous, then we've learned that this looks ridiculous. It's so nice, I can already tell the difference with clean brush. This one's kind of a green up here. We're gonna go for it. Doing eyeliner first and then falsies. That's what I said in the last one. And then I do another layer of black liquid eyeliner over that. And even though I don't like doing a wing on me, with these bird appliques, wings are good, I think. Let's see if we can do waterline. A little bit. Okay, time for these falsies again. What did I do with my eyelash glue? Yeah. Oh, guys, falsies just can make a difference sometimes. If you watched my previous video, you probably heard me talking about how I built these and why I built these appliques. One of the reasons was to save time, because at least half the people who have to wear these have a quick change that they do. And the girls or the dancers who would wear the Bluebird one, or one of the people who would have a quick change out of a demi-soloist position into this creature with feathers and wings and stuff like that. And I mean, for years, changing into a bird costume and putting on this full face of face paint was totally doable. But this, I think, just made things a little less stressful and way easier. And because you never know what can go wrong, it's live theater. I definitely count my blessings, because with most eyelashes, I don't have to trim them. Some people's eyes just in length are a little shorter, some are a little longer, and they have to adjust eyelashes, and if you do, no shame. These are your eyes that you were given, and they're beautiful. Really nice. Up close. I don't know. Let's just go ahead and stick these things on. Oh, you know what? We do this now, before I forget again. For some people, this makes a huge difference. For me, it just kind of helps kind of get my eyelashes in with the fake ones. I'm always scared that when I sneeze, I'm going to blow my eyelashes off. Taped up this one already. Put a piece here, and I put a piece on the edge. And I'm going to lay this with these like rhinestones down here, kind of where my eyebrow is. And bam. Oh yes. Just light. And oh, let's see. It doesn't quite matter which one goes on what side. If you get this, you do what you want. And I will repeat, this is my favorite stuff. You can find it. It's called Problem Solved. That any kind of body clothing tape will work. You know what? Let's go ahead and do blush now. It might not really make a big difference. Maybe not for me. But there's stuff going on my cheeks. Apparently if I get back here, it'll work as well. So if you can guess what music is playing right now, I will give you a shout out, maybe on Instagram or the next video. I'll pick when I get there. Side, make sure he's lined up. He's even. Okay, I feel like I'm gonna go fight in the Trojan War or something. You might have to use my eyelash glue to kind of get this under control, but everyone's bone structure is also kind of different. Who knows? Alright, this last one. This up again to make sure we are even. Look at that. She's so different. I want to see what doing some dramatic white would look like. Got a really nice shimmery guy up here. Let's add finishing touches. Do more eyeliner down here. These are things that I decide to do after the look is pretty much complete. Up into that wing. Okay, let's add some gems. I wanted to stick these really pretty guys on my face, but they're actually really big. So I'm gonna pull out, this is kind of messy, this little guy, and he's got all sorts of fun things in here. I have spilled this everywhere and I have had to reorganize my whole little rhinestone collection. Alright, give me just a second. I'm gonna stick these on my face and we'll see what the end result looks like. Alright, add a few things. As you can tell, there was a lot of extra mesh on this side, so things kept falling off. But this is just sort of what it might look like. She feels like she's staying on really well. So, hopefully this was a lot shorter. Thank you everybody for watching. Hope that you found this entertaining on another one of our lovely quarantine days. And this actually isn't blocking my vision as much as I thought it would be. But have a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful rest of your day. Thoughts and prayers go out to everybody. If you haven't done so yet, please hit the subscribe. Or might be on this side, I don't know, wherever it is. And you can follow me at Designs by Jewels on Instagram. I'm also on Etsy at, I think it's Bejeweled and Bedazzled. It might be Bedazzled and Bejeweled, J-U-L-E, because I've had to switch